everybody, I Shit in the Nude here, and welcome back to another video that'll make you go, ugh! Today we're going to, once again, be making a video about Star Wars. Now, Star Wars, as we know, has a lot of unique and diverse planets that exist throughout its galaxy, which are filled with all kinds of races of creatures, such as Tusken Raiders, Jawas, that thing. So today we're going to be making a tier list of the best planets in the Star Wars galaxy, and this will once and for all prove which planet is the best one. So I have all the rankings right over here on the side. Zooey Mama being the best, Awooga being the second best, being kind of like middling, you know. Wynn's Dad Coming Home being second to last, and finally followed by GTFO, which of course stands for Gordon's Tearing My Fucking Ass Up. Oh man. Alright, I got my handy dandy, way chunkier than it needs to be laptop right here, so let's go ahead and rank these bad boys. So the first one right here is Tatooine. It's where everything began. It's where the movies first started, so I'm gonna put it at Awooga. Now, I am aware that it might not be visually interesting because it's a desert planet, but I can assure you that there are not that many desert planets in the Star Wars lexicon anyway, so, yeah. Am I using that word right? Hold on. Yeah, okay. All right, okay, I guess I'm using that word right. Next planet, I have Geonosis, and I'm going to have to put that at... Wynn's Dad Coming Home. It is a pretty cool planet. I really do like the fact that it's a desert planet, which we actually don't get a lot of those in the Star Wars galaxy. Those are very few and far between. But I really don't really like Geonosis that much because we don't actually get to see much of the outside of the planet in the movie. We just go like inside this factory, which is a shame because I really like the planet because it's a desert planet. Alright, next up on the Star Wars planet tour bus is Jakku, and I'm gonna have to put that at, you know, it's an interesting planet. I really like the fact that it's a desert planet, which we actually don't get to see a lot of those in the... God damn it! We actually don't get a lot of those in the Star Wars galaxy. That being said, though, I'm a little disappointed that there's all, like, this junk and stuff around, you know. Somebody who, like, owns that planet needs to do, like, a little bit of spring cleaning. Okay, next up on this tier list, now, I am kind of cheating a bit here because I did say previously that I'm going to be ranking all these Star Wars planets, but I actually am throwing in some moons into the mix right here. So I decided to go with a prominent location from Rogue One, A Star Wars Story. And that is Jeddah, which is actually a desert moon. And I'm going to have to put that at Awooga. I really like this because it's very different from your typical Star Wars planet. You know, this is a moon, as I've said. But it's also cool because it's not just a moon. It's a desert, you know. And I think the fact that they were able to combine a moon with such an underappreciated environment... in the Star Wars universe. I'm glad that they mixed those two together to make this very cool planet. Alright, next up from the animated show, we have Ryloth, which is a desert planet, but we don't really get to see much of the sand, so I'm going to have to put that at Wynn's Dad Coming Home, because my dad said he was going to Ryloth, and I would always watch the show on Cartoon Network, and whenever we got to that planet, I would always look for my dad, and he just wasn't there, so I know everybody says that Dave Filoni is like a really cool animation director, but the fact that he overlooked putting my dad in the show kind of upsets me a bit, so that's why I'm gonna have to put that there. So next up from the show The Mandalorian, we have Mandalore itself, which I'm gonna have to put that at GTFO. It is a desert planet, which I think is a really cool environmental element, and I think one that's unrepresented within the Star Wars galaxy, but you know, we spend a lot of time on like this this city, and I don't know, man. And also, I don't really know what the Mandalorians look like because they're all wearing their helmets. I don't know if they're like looking serious like under their helmets, or if they have like their tongue out, You know, and I could be having a conversation with the Mandalorian and he could be like mocking me under his helmet. And that's why that place just makes me uncomfortable. And I don't know. And I just have trust issues with anybody that wears like a helmet. Next up, we got, honestly, I don't know what this planet is, but it's a desert planet. So I'm putting it at Zooey Mama. So I'm just going to assume that the entirety of it is a desert. Okay, I actually just did get a confirmation from my producer that it is Passana from The Rise of Skywalker. But let me ask you, do you really care? Hey, speaking of mediocre conclusions, and no, I don't mean my sex life, we have, once again, from The Rise of Skywalker, Exegol, which not a lot of people know this because it's all stormy and stuff like that. It is a desert planet, so I'm going to once again have to put that at Awuga, because I think the desert looks really cool at night. I don't think we've ever gotten, like, a desert at night in any of these movies, so, like, seeing this is, you know, very groundbreaking, and it broke new ground, and I really appreciate it. Next up is Moriband, which I don't know anything about Moriband, honestly. So, I'm honestly going to have to call my friend about that. Hey, what's the planet Moriband? Isn't it, like, is it from Star Wars?
I'm fairly positive it's a Star Wars planet.
I was just checking, because I'm having a conversation with a woman about Star Wars. No, I'm just kidding. Alright, next up on our list, we are going to be ranking the desert planet from Spaceballs. I can't do this shit anymore! How many fucking desert planets does one galaxy need? I can't keep up the facade! Not the rouge! I'm wasting my life! I fucking can't take it anymore! I'm done! I'm done!
As human beings, the first moment of our lives is our most painful. We are thrown into a cold, bright, sterile world with no warning, stripped from our mother's womb, where all we knew was warmth. We as human beings crave warmth, simplicity, to be alone. Deserts have all of these things: warmth, simplicity, a chance to be alone. And yet, they're viewed as a terrible place. Torturous, deadly, never-ending. Can we as humans ever return to those simplistic moments in our lives when everything was bliss? Or are we now conditioned to view them as anything but? Is the sole desire to return to that first moment of our lives greater than the feeling of actually being there in the first place? As I walk through the empty desert that is my life, I often wonder, is death really the end, or is it birth?
All right, I'm going to have to put that guy right here at Back That Ass Up. Okay, and that should be a pretty good ranking of all 12 men from 12 Angry Men. Alright, everybody, well, thank you for watching this video, and if you liked it, fuck you.